There are various models of pulse oximeter devices out there, and this is one of them, Alvital Fingertip Pulse Oximeter from a company called Leadtek Research. In this pulse oximeter review, I will also show you how to correctly use a fingertip pulse oximeter and identify the safe reading levels. This model is called AT101 Series. It comes in a pretty simple looking box. On the box is the image of the pulse oximeter and mentions some of its features. The company that makes this product is based in Taiwan, and the oximeter is also made in Taiwan. Now, let's open the box and see the contents. This is the Alvital pulse oximeter. Comes with a AAA battery and a lanyard. This card shows that there is a professional pulse oximeter app for continuous monitoring of oxygen saturation. The app is available for iOS and Android. And it looks like you can use it while you sleep and get an overnight oximetry report. On the other side is another app called Amore Healthkeeper, which seems to be a tool for recording and monitoring your health data. This is the pulse oximeter user manual. It has quite a lot of details, but I wish that it was made in the form of a booklet with larger fonts. Although I can read them, it is not very comfortable due to small font sizes. Pulse oximetry is a measure of how much oxygen is in the blood. Using this Alvital pulse oximeter, you can measure your blood oxygen saturation and pulse rate. Before using this pulse oximeter, insert a AAA battery. One is already provided in the box. This device is actually very easy to use. Press to open up the oximeter and put one of your fingers into the opening. Make sure the finger is facing up where the sensor is. And then, release the clamp. The device will turn on automatically once a finger is inserted. Wait for a few seconds and the readings will be displayed. There are two different readings shown. This is the oxygen saturation percentage of blood SpO2. And this is the pulse rate. Ideal pulse oximeter readings are oxygen saturation levels of 95% to 100%, which is considered normal. Values under 95% are considered low. This shows that I have a healthy blood oxygen level. When the finger is removed, the device shows finger out and then automatically powers off. As indicated in the user manual, this fingertip pulse oximeter supports wireless Bluetooth connection. Let's test this by using the pulse oximeter app. Scan the QR code on the provided card to find the right app. Install the app from Leadtek Research. Launch the app, read and agree to disclaimer notice, choose your location access preference. Currently, Bluetooth is off. Turn on Bluetooth and insert a finger into the oximeter. The oximeter will turn on automatically and show readings. On the app, click to refresh the devices list. Once the device is detected, click to select it. You can now remove the finger. The app has now loaded but is not showing any data. I am inserting the finger again and the oximeter turns on and shows readings. As you can see here, the phone is also showing the readings as it is connected via Bluetooth. The app keeps record of the oximeter readings as can be seen in the list here. Clicking on individual records will show the graph and data for blood oxygen saturation and heart rate. Under settings, you can also set an alarm to trigger when your oxygen level or heart rate passes set ranges. This is useful when monitoring someone who is not feeling well. By short pressing this button, you can rotate the display data according to your preference. By long pressing this button, it loads the settings option. There are three options here: brightness, timer, and default. Short press to navigate the options and long press to select an option. If you need to monitor your blood oxygen level or heart rate with an easy-to-use, convenient and portable device, this Alvital fingertip pulse oximeter does a great job. You can use it to monitor for health purposes or during fitness exercises. I have included links below if you need to find out more about this device. On TechTube TV, I make useful and easy-to-understand videos on technology-related topics. If you like my content, please consider clicking the subscribe button to follow my future video uploads. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon.